ma, tabangi gud ko sa akong module.
Ay nak, mag-deliver para ba ko aning mga inutaw? Ato lang sa imong ati patudlo ha. Basi nakahinumdom pa siya ni Ana ang leksyon.
Dili ako musugot nga mapakang ang pagtuon sa atong kabataan. Bisan ubos kita sa pandemya karon. Dawata kining gasa sa edukasyon. Kinasingkasi nga halad gikan ning inyong pamunuan.
Gidalik kaninyo ni Mayor Edgardo Labella, Vice Mayor Michael Lopez Rama, ang Chairman sa Committee on Education sa atong konseho, Department of Education, Cebu City Division, Cebu City Local School Board ug Home Radio 106.7, kining Cebu City Educational Laboratory on Radio o Ed Radio. Ed Radio, atong dalit aron mas musayong ang pagkat-on sa atong mga tinun-an gamit ang learning modules pinaagi sa pagpaminaw sa ilang mga paboritong teacher broadcasters sa kahanginan. Tune in na sa 106.7 kay matod ni Mayor ang pagkat-on kinahanglan magpadayon.
Ka, anak, andaman ng imuhang module. Kung maminaw na sa Ed Radio, kay magsugod ng imuhang klase.
Yes, pa! Andam na ko! Come on, classmates! Pwede na ba mo sa ito ang klase karon? Maminaw ba ito ang tarong ni teacher, ha? Teacher! Andam na mi!
Paminaw akining akong pagsibya para ginis sa inyo ha. Sultian ta mo sa ato ang klase. Diri sa MAPEH kita mag happy happy. Tara na magkat-unta. Tara na magkat-unta. Tara na magkat-unta. Sa MAPEH nga nindot og walay sama. Music arts P sa music manganta taninyo. Music arts piug health. Diri sa arts mag drawing taninyo. Music arts piug health. Diri sa PE manayo taninyo. Music arts piug health. Diri sa health mag health check taninyo. The best gid ang MAPEH kauban mo. Lingaw gid kaayo basta na amo. Nindot diri paminaw lang mo perme. With teacher heart ka easy ra sa klase. Tara na magkat-unta. Tara na magkat-unta. Tara na magkat-unta. Sa MAPEH nga nindot ug walay sama.
Good afternoon o maayong hapon sa tanan natong suking tigpaminaw. Lakip na sa atong mga supportive o active ng mga ginikanan. Sa atong mga pinalanggang estudyante, ilabi na sa mga anaa sa ikaunong nga ang-ang o grade 6. O sa tanan nga naminaw karon sa atong pagsibya diri sa kahanginan. Hello, hello, hello ninyong tanan! Hilig ba mo og drawing, painting, printmaking, magbuhat-buhat og lain-lain nga crafts, o di ka ha, digital painting? Di mag-uul! Ani-ana ang atong klase sa kahanginan para sa Arts 6! Ayaw na ibalhin ang istasyon, magkat-on kita!
Welcome to the fun and creative world of Art 6. I am Miss Hannah K. Dilumbar, aka Teacher Heart,
inyong teacher broadcaster matag Sabado, sugod sa 3:00 sa hapon hangtod sa 4:00 sa kahaponon. Dire lang sa atong programang Klase sa Kahanginan at Radio na mapapinaw sa 106.7 Home Radio. Balikon ko, kini si Teacher Heart ang inyong teacher sa arts nga hearty pero dili arte. Good afternoon once again. I hope you're all doing well in your homes and that you are in good health wherever you are listening right now. But before we start our lesson, make sure that you are in a well-lighted and comfortable place to stay. If possible, choose a quiet place so that you can hear our lessons clearly. Also, kindly prepare your pen, papers, and module, the Arts Quarter 1, Module 2, entitled Elements and Principles of Arts and Design, as we will be using them in our class on air today. Parents and guardians are welcome to listen as well so that you can guide your children in answering the modules. Now, do you have your modules with you? Are you ready? All right! In this module, you will be able to identify elements and principles of arts and design that are still applied in art processes using new technologies. This module has two lessons. Lesson 1, Elements and Principles of Arts, and Lesson 2, Apply Concepts of Elements and Principles of Arts and Design on the Use of Paint Application. At the end of the module, you are expected to apply the elements of arts and principles of design in a logo using new technology. Let's get started! Kindly turn your modules to page 2. On this page, you can see there the words What I Know beside the pencil icon. There is a 10-item test on this page in which you have to answer so as to assess your knowledge on the topics that we will be having. Now listen carefully. These are the directions. Write the letter of the correct answer on a separate sheet of paper. Do not forget to write your name, grade, section, subject, quarter, and module number. Again, write the letter of the correct answer on a separate sheet of paper. Do not forget to write your name, grade, section, subject, quarter, and module number. I will be reading to you the questions and choices twice. Then, you will be given 3 seconds to write your answers on your paper. Are you ready, students? Very good! Let's begin! Number 1. A two-dimensional design encased by line to signify its height and width structure. A. Form, B. Color, C. Shape, D. Space. Again for number 1, a two-dimensional design encased by line to signify its height and width structure. A. Form, B. Color, C. Shape, D. Space. And the correct answer is C, shape. Very good for those who got a correct answer. Number 2. An element consisting of use of which there are 3 properties. U, chroma intensity, and value. A, form, B, color, C, lines, D, shapes. Again, number 2. It is an element consisting of use, of which there are 3 properties. U, chroma intensity, and value. What do you think is this, students? A, form, B, color, C, lines, or D, shapes? Okay, for that number, the correct answer is letter B, color. Number 3. It refers to the degree of perceivable lightness of tones within an image. A, value, B, balance, C, movement, D, proportion. Again, number 3. It refers to the degree of perceivable lightness of tones within an image. A, value, B, balance, C, movement, or D, proportion. Okay, the correct answer is letter A, value. Who among you got a correct answer? Very good. Number 4. Repeating a sequence having it occur more than a few times. A, form, B, design, C, alignment, or D, repetition. Again, for number 4, it is repeating a sequence having it occur more than a few times. A, form, B, design, C, alignment, or D, repetition. And the correct answer is letter D, repetition. Okay, let's have number 5. The act of keeping design objects in line, not only vertically or horizontally, but across any linear plane. A, design, B, balance, C, alignment, or D, white space. Again, number 5, what do you think is the act of keeping design objects in line, not only vertically or horizontally, but across any linear plane? A, design, B, balance, C, alignment, or D, white space. If you answered letter C, that's correct. That's alignment. Number 6. A concept based on human perception and the complex nature of the human senses of weight and proportion. A, balance, B, harmony, C, contrast, or D, proportion. Again, for number 6, a concept based on human perception and the complex nature of the human senses of weight and proportion. A, balance, B, harmony, C, contrast, D, proportion. Write your answers on your paper. And the correct answer is letter A, balance. Now let's move on to number 7. It is a basic tool in the Microsoft Paint application that lets you draw with different colors. A, crop, B, pencil tool, C, airbrush, or D, paintbrush tool. Again, for number 7, it is a basic tool on the Microsoft Paint application that lets you draw with different colors. A, crop, B, pencil tool, C, airbrush, or D, paintbrush tool. And the correct answer for number 7 is B, pencil tool. Next, number 8, a tool used to position and enter text into an image. A, crop, B, text tool, C, airbrush tool, D, paintbrush tool. Again, number 8, a tool used to position and enter text into an image. A, crop, B, text tool, C, airbrush tool, or D, paintbrush tool. If you answered letter B, that's correct. It's text tool. Let's have number 9. You are working on an image and you want to achieve a specific shade of color, but you find it difficult to pick the right shade. What tool will help you achieve your desired color? A, pen tool, B, pencil tool, C, airbrush tool, D, eyedropper tool. Again, for number 9, you are working on an image and you want to achieve a specific shade of color, but you find it difficult to pick the right shade. What tool will help you achieve your desired color? A, pen tool, B, pencil tool, C, airbrush tool, or D, eyedropper tool. the correct answer is letter D, eyedropper tool. Now let's have the last but not the least, number 10. You want to get a detailed view of an image. What tool will make it possible for you? A. Pencil tool, B. Airbrush tool, C. Eyedropper tool, or D. Magnifying glass tool. Again, for number 10, you want to get a detailed view of an image. What tool will make it possible for you? A. Pencil tool, B. Airbrush tool, C. Eyedropper tool, or D. Magnifying glass tool. If you answered letter D, then you are correct. It is a magnifying glass tool. Very good, students. Now, we're through with the pre-test. Who among you got a perfect score of 10? How about 9? 8? Or 7? Good job, students! Now, don't worry if you get a low score, since that is just a test on your prior knowledge about the topics that we are going to discuss. You still have the chance to gain a perfect or high score in our post-test if you will just listen attentively in our discussion. Now, let's give everyone a nice clap for a job well done in the pre-test. Do you know how to clap this nice clap? Very good. Okay, I will tell you. You will say, N-I-N-I-C-N-I-C-E, you're nice. Again, N-I-N-I-C-N-I-C-E, you're nice. Okay, your turn. Now, let me ask you, my dear students, what comes to your mind when you hear the word arts? Does it mean anything to you? Did you think about colorful drawings, paintings, and sculpture? Then you're absolutely right! Yes, drawings, paintings, and sculpture are examples of arts. Yet, my dear students, arts is not just limited to those things. Arts is so much more than those that I've mentioned. Arts is the expression or application of human creative skill and imagination, typically in a visual form such as painting or sculpture, producing works to be appreciated primarily for their beauty or emotional power. There are 7 different forms of art, like painting, sculpture, literature, architecture, cinema, music, and theater. Yes, the movies you love to watch and the songs you want to sing are examples or forms of art. Even the buildings that you see. Yes, they are forms of art. Art, in its broadest sense, is a form of communication. Do you have an idea why it is considered as a form of communication? Well, art is an act of expressing feelings, thoughts, and observations. It simply means that when we see a piece of art, it seems like we are getting the message, thoughts, and emotions of its artist. Isn't it amazing? Now, arts wouldn't be complete without its elements and principles. Yes, arts also have its elements and principles. Now, students, kindly turn your modules to page 3. Yes, and you can see there on page 3, lesson 1, elements and principles of arts and design. Now, on the same page, you can see there the words what's in beside the puzzle icon. Under that, you can see there a chart. Written are elements of arts and principles of design. Now we are going to read the elements of arts and principles of design. Are you ready, students? Very good! My students are really active and very attentive. That's right. Now, let me read first the words written inside the chart. Then you're going to repeat after me and then you will have your own time reading the words. Would that be okay? Very good, students! Now, listen to me. Elements of arts. Lines. Shapes. Form. Color. Space. Texture. Value. Now kindly repeat after me. Lines. Shapes. Form. Color. Space. Texture. Value. Very good! Those are the different elements of arts. Now, can you read them once again on your own? Very good! Now let's proceed to the principles of design. Principles of design. Alignment. Balance. Contrast. Emphasis. Harmony. Movement. Proportion. Repetition. Unity. White space. Now repeat after me. Principles of design. Alignment. Balance. Contrast. Emphasis. Harmony. Movement. Proportion. Repetition. Unity. White space. Very good. Now your turn. Very good, students! Kindly move on to page 4 of your arts module. Now, let's do the what's new or what is it activity on that page. Let's look at the pictures. What can you see from the first picture? Yes, on figure 1. Okay, that's a dog. How about on figure 2? Okay, that's like a boy coming out of a picture frame. And figure 3, what is that? Okay, that's an insect. How about on figure 4? Okay, there's like a sprout coming out from the road blocks. Now, all you have to do is to look at the pictures and then put a check on the elements and principles on the figure indicated on the tables below. Write the correct answers on your MAPEH notebook. So, for example, on figure 1, for number 1, elements of arts present in the images above. So, for figure 1, if you can see their lines, you check lines. If you can see shape in that picture, you check shape. If you can see form, color, texture, or value, you check the appropriate boxes. The same with figure 2. And then on the next page, number 2, there are elements of arts that are used as subordinate or background. So you use or you look at figure 3 and figure 4. And then for number 3, elements of arts were used to set contrasts, you look at figure 2 and figure 4. Now, you can do this during your free time later. Now, let's move on. Kindly turn your modules to page 5. Okay, what are the elements of arts? As we can remember, we have lines, shape, form, color, space, texture, and value. Let's have lines first. What can you remember about lines? Okay, lines are marks moving in space between two points whereby a viewer can visualize the stroke movement, direction, and intention based on how the line is oriented. Now, there are different examples of lines. Can you remember some? Okay, we have horizontal lines, vertical lines, diagonal lines, curved lines, spiral, and wavy lines. Yes, okay, now can you look at around you? Can you see lines? Very good, that's great. Almost everything around us are made up of lines. Yes, definitely. Let's have number two, which is shape. Shape is a two-dimensional design encased by lines to signify its height and width structure, and can have different values of color used within it to make it appear three-dimensional. Beside the definition of shapes on your module, you can see some examples of shapes. Okay, you have square, triangle, circle, some irregular shapes. Now, there are also other examples of shapes. Can you name some? Very good. Okay, we also have hearts, diamonds, oblongs, rectangles, and what else? Crescents. Very good. For number three, its form is a three-dimensional object with a volume of height, width, and depth. Again, form is a three-dimensional object with a volume of height, width, and depth. See the examples shown beside the meaning of form. That's on page 5 of your module. Okay, so those are examples of forms. Let's have color on page 6 of your modules. Color is an element consisting of hues, of which there are three properties: hue, chroma intensity, and value. Now look at the example shown on your module. Okay, you can see there yellow, green, blue, purple, red, orange, and yellow colors. Yes, inside the spectrum. Okay, very good. Now, kindly look around you. Can you see different colors? Yes, students? Now, close your eyes and kindly imagine a world without colors. What do you think would it be like? Well, it would just be like the total darkness, just like when you close your eyes. It's black. Yes, because black is the absence of colors. Let's have space. Space refers to the perspective and proportion or size between shapes and objects, and how the relationship with the foreground or background is perceived. Now, kindly look at the example shown on page 6 of your module. Okay, you can see there a hand and then inside a big circle. Okay, that is a comparison of the shape, the relationship of the foreground with its background. Okay, now let's have number 6, texture. Texture is used to describe the surface quality of the work, referring to the types of lines the artist created. Now, texture will be something like how rough or how smooth or what you can feel when you see the artwork of an artist. It might have something to do with how he or she created his or her lines that make it appear as rough or smooth, and also with the materials that he is going to use in his or her artwork. Yes. Now, last but not the least, we have value. Value refers to the degree of perceivable lightness of tones within an image. Now, in a value, there you can see the lightness or darkness of tones, just like the example shown or presented on your module. Okay, very good. Now, let's move forward to page 7. What are the principles of design? Okay, first, we have alignment. Now, this alignment is the act of keeping design objects in line, not only vertically or horizontally, but across any linear plane. Now, when you make your artwork, make sure that you follow the proper alignment. Yes, so that it will not be distracting to look at. Now, kindly look or refer to the picture shown beside alignment. Okay, that is an example. Now, let's have balance. Balance, designs in balance have the arrangement of their parts planned, keeping a coherent visual pattern, like color, shape, or space. Balance is a concept based on human perception and the complex nature of the human senses of weight and proportion. Yes, balance is very important in an artwork. Why? Because if there is no balance, your artwork will not be equally done. Okay, very good. Now, let's have the third principles of design. It's called contrast. Distinguishing by comparing or creating differences. Some ways of creating a contrast among elements in the design include using contrasting colors, sizes, shapes, locations, or relationships. Okay. Now, in contrast, you may use contrasting colors in your art piece, like dark versus light colors, or you may have your sizes, like the others are big ones and then the others are small ones in your artwork. That shows contrast and it attracts the viewers also. Now, let's have number 4, emphasis. It can be achieved in graphic design by placing elements on the page in positions where the eye is naturally drawn by using other principles such as contrast, repetition, or movement. Emphasis is usually done when you want to emphasize something on your artwork. You make it the center of your art piece. Now let's have movement. It is the path the viewer's eye takes through the work of art, often to focal areas. Such movement can be directed along lines, edges, shape, and color within the work of art, just like the example presented. Now let's have proportion. What do you think is proportion? Okay. It is the relationship of two or more elements in a design and how they compare with one another. Yes, as you can see on the example presented, the picture shows that the body is not proportionate, or the other half is not proportionate with the other. Yes, when you do art, everything should be in proportion. Now let's go to number 7, repetition. It's repeating a sequence, having it occur more than a few times. In design, repetition creates visual consistency in page designs, such as using the same style of headlines, the same style of initial capitals, or repeating the same basic layout from one page to another. Okay, kindly look at the example shown on your module. That's an example of repetition. Because as you can see, the design there is consistently repeated. Now, let's have unity. It is a feeling of wholeness, usually achieved when the parts complement each other in a way where they all have something in common. Now, your artwork should be united. They should be connected to one another. That's how to show unity. Now, kindly turn your modules to page 9. You can see there the last but not the least principles of art and design, and that will be white space. Okay, what is a white space? Now, white space in areas of a design void of text or graphics. White space includes margins, gutters, space between lines of type, offset of text from images, and any other part of the page that is empty. So that is a white space. Now, do you have any questions, students? Okay, can you still remember the elements of art that we talked about? How about the principles of design? Very good, students. You really listened well to our discussion. Okay, now, on the same page, page 9 of your module, you can see there what I have learned. The question is, if you are an element of art, what element are you and why? Now, you answer this during your free time or after our class this afternoon. Let's do the activity on page 10, entitled, What I Can Do. Directions. Based on the image above, answer the following questions. Okay, you try to look at the image on page 10. That is a logo of Inaya 1 Elementary School. Okay, for number 1, put a check on the elements of arts present in the school logo. Okay, you have their lines. Does the logo have a line? Okay. So, that's lines, shape, form, texture, value. Okay, so the answer for number 1, the elements of arts present in the school logo are lines, shape, texture, and value. There is no form. For number 2, how many objects are present in the logo? Okay, you're right. There are 4 objects present in the logo. Very good. Number 3, what are the elements of design being used in the logo? Very good. Okay, the elements of design present or being used in the logo are alignment, balance, contrast, emphasis, white space, repetition, and proportion. There is no movement. Very good, everyone. That's all for lesson 1, students, elements and principles of art and design. I hope you did understand and enjoyed our discussion for lesson 1. Now at this juncture, I will give you a 1-minute health break so that you can drink water or stretch your bodies out. Enjoy your 1-minute health break. We will be back after that. Let's continue our discussion for lesson 2, entitled Microsoft Paint Menus and Tools. Now, students, open your modules on page 11. Look at the words inside the box under what's in of page 11. Let's read all together the words. Number 1, selection tools. 2, eraser tool. 3, fill tool. Number 4, eyedropper tool. Number 5, zoom tool. 6, pencil tool. Number 7, paintbrush tool. Number 8,
airbrush tool. 9, text tool. 10, line tool. 11, curve tool. And 12, shapes tools. Very good, everyone. Now you may turn your modules to page 12. Okay, can you see the different icons presented on page 12? What do you think are those? Which is the icon for Microsoft Paint? Can you guess? Okay, very good. The first one is the icon for Microsoft Paint. Do you know what is a Microsoft Paint? Okay, students, listen carefully. Microsoft Paint is a simple raster graphics editor that has been included with all versions of Microsoft Windows. Do you know where we can find the Microsoft Windows? Okay, it's an operating system of our computers or our laptops. Now, the program opens and saves files in Windows Bitmap, JPEG, GIF, PNG, and single-page TIFF formats. The program can be in color mode or two-color black and white, but there is no grayscale mode. For its simplicity, and that is included with Windows, it rapidly became one of the most used applications in the early versions of Windows, introducing many to painting on a computer for the first time. It is still widely used for simple image manipulation tasks. Now take a look at the image presented on page 12. Okay, that is the title bar. Understanding how to read the title bar is a basic skill in Windows. The icon at far left gives you a clue as to what program the window belongs to. In this case, the icon shows that the window belongs to Microsoft Paint. If you can see the paintbrush and the palette of colors, that means that that application belongs to Microsoft Paint. Now, students, turn your modules to page 13. Let's have tools. What are tools? Microsoft Paint has an assortment of painting tools that you can use for drawing shapes and applying color to areas of your image in various ways. You switch between tools by clicking on the appropriate icon on the toolbar, which is located on the left side of the paint window. Now you can see the sample tools that you can see on the tools or toolbar section of your Windows Paint. Now let's have the different kinds of tools. The first is the selection tool. These tools are used to select portions of the image you're working with. These selections can then be moved around, copied, or edited without affecting the rest of the image. It looks like a rectangular box as shown on the image beside the selection tool. Now let's have the eraser tool. The eraser tool is simple to use. Just click on it to select it, then click on the part of the image that you want to erase. The eraser tool looks just like an eraser. The fill tool applies color or paint to a large area of the image. The icon for the fill tool resembles a pouring jar of paint, just like if you were pouring a liquid in real life. The fill tool's paint will fill an area's shape with color, and you can look at the icon on page 13. Next is the eyedropper tool. The eyedropper tool has only one function, but it is a useful one. The eyedropper can be used to pick up colors that you've already used in an image. The dropper tool looks like a medicine dropper. Let's move on to the magnifying glass on page 14. The magnifying glass or zoom tool can be used to get a closer, more detailed view of an image. This is very useful if you're working in close with the fine details of a part of an image. The magnifying glass tool or zoom tool just looks like a magnifying glass. Next, the pencil tool.
the pencil tool is your basic drawing tool. You can draw in different colors, but other than that, there are no other options. The pencil tool looks like a pencil. Next, we have the text tool. The text tool is used to position and enter text into your image. The text may be of any color or font that you have activated on your computer. The text tool icon looks like letter A, just how it is being presented on your module on page 14. Next, we have the straight line tool. The straight line tool is easy to work with. You can change the color and width of your lines by using the toolbar options. Then we have the curve tool. The curve tool is trickier to use than the line tool. It can be difficult to learn how to use, and it is difficult to explain. Next, we have the shapes tools. The shapes tools are very similar, so we'll look at them all at once. We have the rectangle tool. The rectangle tool draws three types of rectangles: outline, filled with outline, and filled without outline. The interior of the outline rectangle is transparent, whereas the filled types fill the rectangle with a background color. Then we have the polygon tool. The polygon tool is similar to the rectangle but works a bit differently. To create a polygon, activate the tool from the toolbar. Then, click on the image wherever you want your first vertex to be. A vertex is like a corner. Draw the edges of the shape like you would use the straight line tool. Then simply connect the last edge to the first vertex and the shape will finish. And then we also have the oval tool. The oval tool works much like the rectangle tool. Then we have the rounded rectangle tool. The rounded rectangle tool is like a cross between the rectangle tool and the oval tool. It draws rectangles, but instead of having sharp 90-degree angle corners, they'll be somewhat rounded. Now, below the definition of round rectangle tool, there is a box there containing different shapes. So those are the examples or the icons used for the shapes tools. Okay, do you get it, students? Very good. Next on the list is the edit menu. The edit menu is where you'll find most of your commands that are useful for working within your file to make changes of one kind or another. We have the undo. Undo is probably the most important single command to remember. Undo will remove the last change you made to the file. Then we have the repeat. Repeat is like the reverse of undo. It will reapply the last change that you made to the file you're working on. Next, the cut command. The cut command will remove the selection from the image just as though you cut it out with a pair of scissors or an X-acto knife. Next, we have copy. Copy works much like cut, in that it places the selected portion of the image into the copy buffer, but it does not remove the selection from where it originally appears in the image. Next, we have paste. Paste is how you get stuff out of the copy buffer and back onto the image. It pastes the contents of the copy buffer back into the image, where you can move it around before deselecting it. Then we have flip. Flip, you can choose between horizontal or vertical for the direction of your flip. This is good if you need to create a mirror image of a selection. Flip is just like using mirror. Next, we have rotate. Rotate will rotate the selection. The rotate command in Paint is not extremely flexible, so you're limited to right angle rotations, that is 90, 180, and 270 degrees of rotation. Okay, those are the different menus and tools of the Microsoft Paint application. Now let's go to page 17 of your module. The activity there is what I have learned. It says, create an image using 5 tools from Microsoft Paint application. Now you can do this later after our class or during your free time. Then turn your modules to page 18. Let's do the activity What I Can Do together. Answer the following questions. Now based on the image above, which are different shapes and there are words of or colors written inside them, let's answer the questions. For number 1, is there an element of arts in the figure? Is there? Okay, if you answer yes, that's the correct answer. Next, number 2. Put a check on the tools present in the figure. Now, what do you think are the tools present in the figure? Does it have fill, shape, flip, line, text, or pencil? Okay, the correct answers are fill, shape, flip, and text. Very good, students. Now let's have letter B. Draw one icon from the Microsoft tool which you like best. I will be giving you 10 seconds to draw your favorite icon. Your time starts now. And that would be all for our lesson 2, which was all about Microsoft Paint menus and tools. I hope you understand our lesson on the different menus and tools of Microsoft Paint. Now at this point, let's have a short recap of what we had discussed this afternoon. Now there are different elements of arts and principles of design. The elements of arts includes lines, shapes, form, color, space, texture, and value. And the principles of design include alignment, balance, contrast, emphasis, harmony, movement, proportion, repetition, unity, and white space. We also discussed about the menus and tools of Microsoft Paint. This includes the selection tools, eraser tools, fill tool, eyedropper tool, zoom tool, pencil tool, paintbrush tool, airbrush tool, text tool, line tool, curve tool, shapes tools, and edit menus. These menus and tools in Microsoft Paint are very useful in doing our artwork in the Paint application. Since we are done discussing our 2 lessons for this afternoon, kindly turn your modules on page 19. And you can see there the assessment. Now you have to answer this assessment on a separate sheet of paper. Let me read to you the directions. Write the letter of the correct answer on a separate sheet of paper. Write your name, grade, section, subject, quarter, and module number. Again, write the letter of the correct answer on a separate sheet of paper. Write your name, grade, section, subject, quarter, and module number. After you answer the assessment, you submit it to your teacher during your scheduled time, and your teacher will be the one to check your assessment answers for you. That would be all for today, students. Thank you for listening, and I hope you enjoyed and learned a lot in our session this afternoon. Don't forget to keep your modules in a clean and safe place to avoid them from getting wet or dirty. Till next time, students! Again, this is Teacher Heart, your teacher broadcaster in Arts 6, who wanna tell the world, the universe rather, to always do art with a heart. Bye-bye!
Luca, anak, kamusta? Humana ba inyo ang klase?
Oo pa! Ang daghana po niyo mga bago nakatunan karon, di ba, classmates?
Wow! Very good!
Classmates! Magkuyog piya gihapon ta sa sunod na tuwa klase, ha?
See you!
Maukadto ang atong kinasingkasing nahalad alang sa atong mga tinunan aron ang pagkat-on magpadayon bisan pa man sa mga kabag-uhan na resulta sa pandemya. Dalit kaninyo sa Cebu City Government Local School Board, Cebu City Council, Department of Education, Cebu City Division ug sa Home Radio 106.7. Atangi ang sunod nga klase sa kahanginan. Hangtod sa sunod higayon, ayaw si Piata sa pagpaminaw sa Ed Radio tungod kay ang pagkat-on kinahanglan magpadayon.